Hey guys, welcome back to my channel, Becoming Britt. Today I'm going to be talking about how I started my lash business, what it's like being a mom, an entrepreneur, a teacher, and all those things all in one. And I'm gonna give you a little haul slash, not tour, but basically everything that I have and what I use in my day-to-day for my business. So I guess I'll get started with how I started my lash business. I was in the car and it just kind of came to me and I was like, I've been thinking about how I can get different streams of income for a while. It came to me and I was like, oh, maybe I can start a lash business. Like, I like makeup and why not just start it? So I began on the hunt for how to start a business, how to start a lash business in particular. I watched an abundance of YouTube videos. I Googled how to build a website. I asked a friend how to do it. I basically did a bunch of research on how to start a business. Then I sought out for a vendor. So I looked on an array of different websites to find a wholesaler who had quality lashes. I started my lash business in February. Actually, I think I started the blueprinting in January. I got my inventory at the end of January. Launched it on February 2nd because I loved the 02/02/2020, just the look of it. It was actually Eddie's idea, and I fell in love with it. So that's when I actually launched my lash business. So now I'm going to show you what I use in the day-to-day for my business. So I got this ring light off of Mercari. I went on there and searched for it. I had some credit because I made a sale. So I went and got this. I think the asking price for it was like maybe $23, but since I sold something, I only paid like $5 for it. So I thought that was a great deal. So my ring light is what I need so that I can take pictures at night when Imara is sleeping. Other things for the pictures. I got these cute little, they're called cardstock background. So I use this for my pictures. I also have a marble one that I use. And then I have this pink glitter grass. So those are the three backgrounds that I use to take my pictures on, just so that it like comes off a little bit more professional. What I also use is a label maker. I got it from Walmart, no more than $20. I can't remember exactly how much, but this is how I label my lashes with their names on it. I have bubble wrap for when I mail them, each one of the lashes into the bubblies, or if I'm stressed, I take some and pop them. Free stuff, but I use this as a journal for me. How is everything going? Some things that I want to maybe do in the future. I basically keep track in this notebook. I got it from Dollar Tree. I just use these tweezers. My first set of inventory, I ordered the case separate from the actual lashes, so I needed to transfer them. So that's what I used this lucky pair of tweezers for. I got this from Dollar Tree and I thought this was really good. Now this is for when somebody orders like one or two pairs of lashes. I just put them in these mailers. And that's why I have the bubble wrap, because these don't have the extra cushion. So I just wrap them in there and then throw them in. I have labels to label all of my products, and you'll see that a little bit later on. Now I'm just gonna show you the inventory of my lashes. So this was the first set of lashes that I received. A lot of them actually sold out, the styles that I had. I may order them because I know a lot of people actually liked those styles. So this is what they originally came in. And then what I did was I transferred them to this and put them inside of this case. Now I have my new lashes, my drip collection, and I'm actually wearing a pair of them now. These are the style Dior. They're 25 mm, that just means that they're really long, and I love them. This is the case that they come in. Drip. I have 6 styles coming out, and I'm gonna show you some. And the names are slowly being released throughout the week, so if you're not following my Lashly Yours Instagram, go ahead and follow us at _LashlyYours and you'll be able to see them. Okay, so that's one style. This one is another. There's another style. Here's another one. So I got this 3-drawer Sterlite set from Walmart a while ago. So I just hold them all in here. That way when they're ready to go, I can just pull them out. This is what I use. I'll link an Amazon link for you just in case you're interested. Then I also have these. These are my pride and joy. I really love these tools. Yeah, I don't even know what else to say about them. They're so cute. So these are my rose gold beauty tools. And it comes with a pair of eyelash tweezers, eyelash curlers, eyelash scissors, just in case they're too long for your eye, you have to cut them, and then regular angle, small angled tweezers. Some kind of hardships that I've had is being consistent. It's very hard. Well, it was hard before the whole quarantine happened, with being consistent, taking pictures, making sure I have content to post on the Lashly Yours page and advertising enough. That was very much a struggle for me. It's gotten a little bit easier since we've been home. So what's it like actually being a momtrepreneur, or however you pronounce it? It's been pretty cool, I would say. I mean, I've just been trying to juggle everything going on. Obviously, I have duties to do in the home. I have duties to my teaching job. But what I try and do is set a time for me to do the business work. And it's mostly after hours, like after Emira has gone to bed, everybody has gone to bed. I will just stay up late until like 1 a.m. trying to see, what can I do? Researching new things, looking for more inventory, seeing how I can just better everything. So really, they say like if you really want something, you have to work for something and you have to make time for it. And that's really what I try and do. I didn't hire anybody to do my website. I just did it all by myself because, one, I wasn't sure if, you know, I was gonna be successful and sustain this. So I didn't wanna spend a bunch of money and not knowing if it was going to last and be worth it. With that being said, I also made my logo. I used the app called Canva to make my logo. And it looks fine to me. I don't know, some graphic designers might say otherwise, but I love my logo, and I was able to do it for free $3.99. So you guys are probably wondering, how much did it cost to start up my business? It did not cost much. I'm trying to think. I think my original investment in everything couldn't have been more than $100, between the lashes and, you know, the label maker, everything. Every time somebody does purchase lashes, I don't profit, but I put it back into my business to make it better. So I save that money so that I can buy new inventory. I can buy, you know, labels. I can buy different mailers. Okay, that is all that I have for you. I hope you enjoyed this video. Like, comment, share, subscribe if you're new here. It just really helps me as a new and growing YouTube channel. If you have any questions about starting your own business, any questions about, you know, finding your vendors or anything, just leave them down below and I'll respond to you and help you as much as I can, because remember, I'm still learning too. Alrighty, enjoy your day.